In this video, we're talking about oxidation or redox reactions. So first of all, what is a redox reaction? Well, it's a reaction where electrons are transferred from one species to another. And when this happens, whatever loses electrons is said to be oxidized. So oxidation means loss of electrons. Whatever gains electrons is said to be reduced. So reduction is gain of electrons. And there's a little mnemonic device to remember this. Oxidation is loss of electrons. Reduction is gain of electrons. Oil rig. So how do we know what's gaining electrons, what's losing electrons? What's oxidized, what's reduced? So if we look at this chemical equation, we see that over here, copper has no charge. It's elemental copper. It's just copper metal. But here, the silver has a positive charge. It's dissolved in water. It's aqueous. And on the right-hand side, though, now copper has gained a positive 2 charge, and silver doesn't have any charge. So you see copper went from a charge of 0 to plus 2. The only way that can happen is if copper is losing 2 electrons. So that means because oxidation is loss, we would say that that copper is being oxidized. And silver has a positive 1 charge here and a 0 charge over here. And the only way that can happen is if each of the silver atoms gains an electron. And because reduction is gain of electrons, we say that silver is being reduced. Now, notice the 2 here. 2 is the balance, well, 2 things, really, the charge and the mass. Copper loses 2 electrons. Each silver, because it has a plus 1 charge, can only gain 1 electron. So we need 2 silver atoms to gain those electrons. One silver atom gains each of the electrons that comes that is given off from the copper. And so we have 2 here and a 2 here to balance the mass. Now, you won't always see the chemical equation written with the charges, but you can still tell a lot of times what's being oxidized and what's being reduced. So for example, in this reaction here, zinc metal and hydrochloric acid to make zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. By the way, do you recognize what type of reaction this is? Yes, right, it's a single replacement reaction. So we want to find out what's oxidized and what's reduced. The simple way to do this is to take anything that's aqueous, okay, write that down. If it's aqueous, and only if it's aqueous, break it apart into its ions, the cation and the anion. So hydrochloric acid will become H plus and Cl minus, and we have 2 here because we have 2 hydrochloric acids. And zinc chloride will become zinc with a positive 2 charge and 2 chloride ions. Make sure you guys understand where these came from. Now the zinc metal, it wasn't aqueous, so it just stays as it was, and same thing with the hydrogen gas. Now if we look at this, we can see that zinc is going from a 0 charge here to a plus 2 charge. That means it must be losing electrons, so it's oxidized. And so zinc is oxidized. That's the answer to that part. And hydrogen goes from a plus 1 to a 0 charge. That means it's gaining electrons, and so hydrogen, the hydrogen ion, is being reduced.